Hey everybody, this is going to be part 7 in my poor man's home gym series, and tonight I'm going to cover grip strength and how I train my grip, and I'm going to show you the device I came up with to do that, I'm going to have to go quick because my battery's getting a little low, and hopefully I can get this in there, okay? What I've got here is this bar it's a pipe that's 2 3/8 inches in diameter. A galvanized pipe, and it goes through these two cement blocks, and you can see that it's just tied in there kind of haphazardly, tied and taped, but anyway, the whole assembly there with the pipe and the two concrete blocks weighs in at about 108 pounds. Okay, well, not about, it is 108 pounds of weighted, and then what I do is I start lifting that, and then as I go I've got these weights set up over here that I can loop onto the ends of here to increase my weight. And what I'm going to do here, I'm going to show you, hopefully, with the tape measure real quick so you can kind of see that this is, in fact, a pretty thick bar here. Hopefully you can see it good enough once I get this on here. I've kind of devised a way to do this here. I'm going to put this video cassette tape up against the back of the bar. So I'm measuring up against that. Let's see here. And then what I'm going to do is look right down over here. Let's see here. You can see that. Oops. See, it's not the most accurate way to do it, but there you go. It's basically right at 2 3/8 in width. As you can see, I've got it pinned up against here, against the back of the bar. Anyway. In the future here, I'm going to borrow my brother's caliper, actually, and bring it over here, and then I'll be able to caliper that and give you the exact measurement. The reason that's important is what I'm trying to do is basically I tried to come up with a device that could approximate the Thomas Inch dumbbell or the Millennium dumbbell. And those dumbbells, if you look them up, they're just a thick handle dumbbell, and they have a handle that's approximately 2 3/8 inches in diameter, and that makes it a lot harder to grip and lift those dumbbells. The Thomas Inch, I believe, weighs 172 pounds. The Millennium weighs like 227, and there are very few guys out there lifting that Millennium dumbbell. But anyway, so this is just an approximation. I know it's not the same thing, but it's the way I train my grip and everything. And I'm just going to go ahead and get started. And hopefully this battery holds out long enough to do this for you. I'm going to try to go quick, okay? And like I said, the two concrete blocks and the two concrete blocks there and the pipe weigh in at 108 pounds. That's what I'm going to start with. And all I do is, one hand basically, try to find the center of this thing. This thing is purposely built to be unwieldy. I want it to be difficult. So the blocks are two different weights. The bar has an elbow down here, not down here. So you just got to find the center best you can. So I'm going to do it with my right hand. This is the 108 pounds here. So 1, 2, 3. Okay, that comes up pretty easy, obviously. That's not much weight. And switch, go left-handed, straighten out, do that. Okay. Trying to go fast because of the battery situation. And then what I'm gonna do is I've got these plates. This is a 25 pound York barbell cast iron plate. And I'm gonna hang that on each side here. And again, I mean, not a perfect system, but it actually makes it more difficult because they're not on there tightly and everything. And I'm gonna hang those on there, okay? And I'm just gonna keep on moving just because I don't have much time here. And so 50 more pounds on the 108, so we're at 158 pounds. And I'm going to grip it and pull it. 1, 2, 3. Okay. Straight. Okay. All right, guys. Straighten that out a little bit. And we'll go ahead and pull it left-handed too. Okay. Grip it at the center. Find the center. Okay. A little bit off center there, but I got it up. So that's 158 pounds. And the next thing I'm going to add on there is these 27 pound plates. Great English there. These are gas main covers that have had a hole torched in them. And these weigh in at 27 pounds each, okay? I'm just gonna hook that on there. And I'm gonna hook one on over here. Okay. All right, guys, so loop it on there best I can. So, right now, that's an extra 54 pounds on top of the 158, so that's 212 pounds. Plus the weight of the extension cord that I used to tie on there, but I mean, big deal as far as that goes. But so here we go, 212 pounds, one hand. Try to find the center best I can. Give it a good tight squeeze here, and then pull. One, two, three. Crap, I had a little off balance there. That shouldn't even be difficult. Alright, so anyway, I'm gonna try it left-handed since I got a little off whack there. Let's see. Okay, so here we go, guys. 212 pounds, left-handed. One, two, three. Okay, a little crooked, but I got it up. Okay. And just to prove that I can do the 212 with my right hand, I'll go ahead and go right back and do it again. And hopefully I have time on my card here. Okay. There we go. Situate it. Like I said, it's very unwieldy, and that's what makes it difficult and fun, you know? Balance point. But anyway, you can see that my grip's plenty strong enough to pull the 212 with either hand on the 2 3/8 inch bar. And tonight, I'm exhausted. It's like 3 o'clock in the morning here. So another night, I'll go ahead and add these 15s and we'll take it all the way up to 245 pounds. Okay. And strap those on there. But anyway, for tonight, that gives you some idea. Here, let me unhook this. Sorry, guys. That gives you some idea of my training with that little device that I've made up. And, you know, it's not a perfect system, but the fact that it's unwieldy and unbalanced, it makes it more difficult, more challenging, and actually make you stronger. So, anyway, I hope you guys enjoy taking a look at this. I'll come back in a later date when I got a little more energy. It's not so late. And I'll see if I can't put up some record numbers. Like I said, my record on this particular device is 245 pounds with my right hand. And I'll come back and duplicate that for you. I'll also, in that video, I'll caliper this pipe so that you can be ensured that it is the 2 3/8 inches that I tried to show you there. And so hopefully you enjoyed this, and I'll catch you guys later. See ya, bye.